So I left a train wreck of a voicemail to a prospective client this week, which has led to this week's 2-Minute Tip Tuesday. So if you've ever left a voicemail that had you saying, "What the Sam hell was that?" after you hung up, then you need to watch this video. So this week I was calling on prospective clients and in some cases getting people's voicemails. And the irony is I even wrote a blog post recently about voicemail etiquette. And if you want to read that article, you can find the link in the description. So I had all the etiquette tips in my head, but then I picked up the phone to this one prospective client and blah. It was just verbal diarrhea, which left me wondering at the end of the call if I had even left my phone number for them to call me back. It was terrible. And I had the little devil on my shoulder going, "You should read your own blog post, dumbass." But I didn't. And the voicemail is now sitting in that poor girl's inbox. And I'm so sorry for that. Here's the thing with voicemail. When you craft an email, you have time to read the words, go back, change the words around, add, delete, and when you're finally happy with the product, then you can hit send. Even with video, you have the opportunity to edit the content before you hit publish. But with voicemail, you sometimes only have one chance to leave a coherent message, because often voicemails don't have that delete and re-record function on the telephone. So here is my own advice that I'm really, really taking to heart this week. And I'm hopeful that this will resonate with you as well, is to script your voicemail and practice it before you even pick up the phone. It's going to take you 4 or 5 minutes to script it out, which is time consuming, but I did it. And wouldn't you know it, I have scribbles and notes all over this script, which means if I would have tried to do this off the top of my head, it would have come out as crap. So now I've scripted it and then I practiced it once. Now when practicing, if it takes me more than a minute to go through my script, then I got to rewrite that script because your voicemail should be under 1 minute. But I am really hopeful that I'm going to save the world from my crappy voicemails by scripting and practicing the voicemail before I even pick up the phone. And friends, this script is not to go to waste after all the time you put into it. If this script actually works or you feel confident reading it, now you can use it for as a base for other calls as well. So there's my 2-Minute Tip Tuesday. Script and practice your voicemails before even picking up the phone, and maybe you won't look like a dumbass like me this week. Thanks for watching. See you next time.